Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Do It Yourself Designs. I'm Marcia. I hope you are doing well. Today I have a gorgeous dress idea to share with you. I saw this TV presenter wearing it and I just fell in love with it. And it has a gingham pattern. One side of the dress is one color and the other side a different color. And I just fell in love with it. So beautiful and very feminine and pretty. So I thought I would like to make this dress, but I would like to make it in a more sustainable way. So I started looking in a charity shop and I found two shirts and they had different colors of gingham. I thought it would be ideal to make this dress. Perfect. One is red and one in blue. Gingham is very fashionable, very trendy this year, and it's always been, but especially this year, is the pattern to be seen in. So I'm so excited about this project. I hope you like this idea. And if you do, please don't forget to press the like button. And I also would like to invite you to take a quick second to subscribe to my channel. Press the little bell so you'll be notified next time I post another video. Thanks very much. So let's get started. This little number is called the picnic dress from the British label Olivia Rose. It is handmade to order, so no fabric and resources are wasted. It became out of stock when the orders increased after British presenter endorsed it. Now it's available to order again. I'll start this project by unpicking the buttons, the placket, side and sleeve seams. This dress has a very simple shape. The top section is a simple basic bodice block with a seam in the middle. And the skirt section, you can use any A-line skirt and then join top and skirt. So you don't really need a pattern for it. But if you prefer to use a pattern, I found this Buttericks B6016 and it's great for this design. I unpicked the collar, the side seams and the placket, and also I cut the sleeves very close to the seams on both shirts. I'm using the Buttericks pattern to cut one side of the dress front, half of the bodice front and half of the skirt, using the front of the shirt. Then I cut the other half of the bodice front in mirror image using the blue color shirt, as you can see. And again, I use the front shirt to cut the other half of the dress front. For the back of the dress, I did the same as the front. I used half the back shirt to cut one side of the bodice and skirt back. I did the same with the other collar shirt to cut the other side of the back in mirror image. Pin and sew bodice side and shoulder seams, press seams open, then finish raw edges with zigzag stitches. Just try it on now, very pleased with the fitting. I was left with some marks from where the pockets was originally in the shirt, so I decided to re-sew it back in place to hide it. And I also added the other pocket from the red shirt to balance it out on the front section of the bodice. I think it looks quite nice, quite unique.
As you can see, I pinned the bodice to the skirt section, matching the seams in the front and side seams, so they look neat, perfectly lined up, and this is very important with this design. I'm very pleased how these seams look so neat, and I pinned also the zipper on the back opening before sewing. I'm using the shirt blue sleeve to cut the right sleeve of the dress, about 10 centimeters. I'll cut around there to make the puff sleeves. The color will be different to the side of the dress that I will attach to. I made a slit in the middle of the arm section, about 5 centimeters in length, and I will add a bias binding to it. Sewed two rows of gathering stitches on a longer stitch length on the sleeve head and in the arm section, adjusting the gathers to fit comfortably. I sewed the tie pieces in the middle and pinned all around right sides together. I left a gap of approximately 34 centimeters in one side of the middle section to attach it to the sleeve. I turned both ties to the right side, as you can see. And then I sewed to the sleeve section in the area where I left open. And I will turn it over and finish off with tiny stitches by hand on the inside afterwards. The dress looks beautiful. I decided to add a belt to this dress. I used the shirt cuffs and joined together with the collar in the middle, removed the buttons and cut the end of each of both sides of the collar piece, folded the edge to match the width of the cuffs and sewed it together. is the final dress? Please write in the comment section if you prefer with or without the belt. I also found these two shirts with pastel shades and made this version of the picnic dress with different sleeve shapes this time. I love it. It's really beautiful. I really recommend making a gingham dress. It is a print that will always come back into play in the warmer months. This dress is amazing. It's super fun to make and it's super comfy to wear. I hope you like this idea. And if you do, please don't forget to press the like button. And I hope you can subscribe to my channel. It will be very much appreciated. Thanks very much and see you again with another video and with another very inspirational idea.